Tonight, a San Diego police officer is fighting to keep a cop killer from becoming a free man. The cold-blooded killer was recently granted parole, and unless the governor steps in, he'll soon be back on the streets.
10 News reporter Preston Phillips is live downtown, and Preston, the officer fighting to keep that killer behind bars was the same person who found the dead officer back in 1978.
Steve, that's right. His name is Bill Ferry. He's been with the San Diego Police Department for 42 years. Ironically, Governor Jerry Brown was also the governor back in 1978 when San Diego police officer Archie Buggs was murdered. His name here etched in glass at the San Diego County Regional Law Enforcement Memorial. Governor Jerry Brown also the governor back in 1979 when Buggs' killer was sentenced to life in prison without the possibility of parole.
It was November 4th, 1978. San Diego police officer Archie Buggs pulled the car over for an open container violation.
The station here is at 7222 Skyline Drive, and the very next block is the 7100, and about where that vehicle is now is where he made the stop on the car.
Officer Buggs lived through the Vietnam War, but not the traffic stop.
You never know what you're going to encounter.
Buggs was shot six times, execution style, by one of two gang members he had pulled over. The gunman, now 53 years old, Jesus Cesena. He was just 17 at the time.
There's a phrase that's used a lot about a routine traffic stop. Any experienced police officer knows there's no such thing as a routine traffic stop.
Officer Bill Farah was the first to arrive on scene and find Officer Buggs.
Came to the scene and I found Archie, of course, still in his uniform, his engine running in his car, face down in the gutter, killed by the gunshot.
Fired by Cesena, who was sentenced to life without parole in 1979. Just 3 years later, though, another court ruled he couldn't be sentenced to life in prison without parole because he was 17 at the time of the killing. In April, the state parole board decided it's time he be released.
And I just don't think that if you premeditate killing an on-duty or off-duty police officer that you should ever get out of prison.
Now Farah and others are writing letters to the governor and the parole board urging them to reverse the decision.
And Cesena's sentence was modified by another court to 7 years to life. He became eligible for parole in 1985. Before the April hearing, he had been denied parole 14 times. Governor Jerry Brown has until September 6th to review the decision. Reporting live tonight outside the County Administration Building, Preston Phillips, 10 News.